Hello guys, and welcome back to the Fortune Hotel. This is a brand new deception show, very, very similar to The Traitors, and it really does seem like they've taken all the best aspects of The Traitors and kind of improved on some of the worst aspects of The Traitors. I'm really enjoying it so far. I feel like it's not really big energy, it's not really hit that peak excitement yet. However, I know I am very, very late on these episodes, so I'm hoping you guys enjoy. I don't know anything that happened in this show. I'm very, very excited to find out what does happen. But so far, after the first episode, I'm very, very optimistic that this is going to be a really, really good series to watch. So guys, if you are enjoying this channel, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. We are on our way to 900. We're making slow progress, but we are getting there, so make sure that we are hitting that subscribe button if we haven't been already. We are going to be catching up on a lot of shows before the summer starts, but until then, let's get into the video and enter the Fortune Hotel. Before we actually start the episode properly, I just want to apologize for the lighting situation. I've come off back off holiday and my light fixture's been changed and the bulbs don't currently work, so little bit of a faff with that. So I'm really having to juggle different light sources. Like currently I'm using light from my window, which I don't normally use. Yeah, it's a little bit of a struggle. It's a little bit of a faff, but we're making do with it. It is what it is. Not really much we can do, but hopefully it will be fixed as soon as possible. Yeah. So let us talk about some of the couples as they came in. I had some good vibes about some bad vibes about some others. I think it's going to be really interesting to see this game be played in duos as opposed to singles, which is kind of what The Traitors is like. The duo aspect of it really does add an extra layer of, ooh, this is fun, this is exciting, this is fresh, this is new. And I also feel like it will help to just provide a little bit more life in this show as well. So we are going to get into just two of the 10 couples that I just had something to say about. I just found it very interesting that Jen and Susan, one of them is a parliamentary advisor in Scotland. The other one is I think she said she was a criminal analyst or something like that. Something along those lines, something like an investigator. She's good at reading people is what I assume it's going to boil down to. But they've decided to come in and lie about their jobs. It's interesting because it's the same thing that happens on The Traitors where people come in and they're like, oh, I don't want to say what my job is because people might take that the wrong way, etc., etc. But actually, I think it's the best choice to lie. That's how I personally feel. We've also got Louis and Chloe. Now, if you've been a fan on the channel for a while, you'll know that Louis is actually on another TV show that we reviewed very recently called Josh Must Win. Josh Must Win, fantastic show. Died a little towards the end, but it was still a good show. And Louis was one of the main characters or main sort of cast members on that. He's now on the Fortune Hotel, and honestly, I don't know whether this was filmed before or after, but it looks like he's had some work done. Either had some work done or he's lost some weight. I don't know quite which one yet. But either way, looking fab. And I found it very interesting that these two seem to have some kind of game plan in the back of their head. I feel like they're uber competitive and I'm really excited to see how they get on. So obviously we're now going to get into the main gameplay element of the game, which is picking their cases. If you don't know how this works, there are 10 cases. Seven of them contain nothing. Two of them contain the cash. And one of them has the dreaded early checkout card. Honestly, I was a little bit skeptical as to how this was going to work. When it was explained to me via like the press release, I was like, I don't really see how this is going to work. But there is £250,000 on the line. Someone is going to win that amount of money by the end of the show. First of all, they've really outshined The Traitors. I'm pretty sure the max you can win on The Traitors is £120,000 in the UK, which is not a great deal of money compared to this. So honestly, £250,000, yeah, I'm big into this. I think this is going to be a really, really cool. A quarter of a mil, absolutely get me in those pockets. So the couples then had to pick their room cards. They randomly chose. I would have chosen number 7, which is the one that Jen and Susan chose. And then we found out who had what briefcase. So, starting with the people who had the money. The people who had the money were Louis and Chloe, obviously. And also Joanne and Will. I found this very interesting because these two people really felt like they were being sort of, what's the word I'm looking for? Edited as if they were like main characters of the episode. Which I feel like that's exactly how it's going to go with this kind of show, is the people who have got the money are the ones that are going to be the focus of the episode, or like the people who are going home, things like that. Unfortunately, Leslie and Gary did get the early checkout card, which meant if they held on to the early checkout card by the end of the day, they would unfortunately have to leave the game. Leslie and Gary, they seem so cool and so sweet and so lovely. And when they opened it and went, oh, for fuck's sake. Oh, for fuck's sake. Oh, God. Oh, no. Oh, what have we done? How are we going to get out of this one, eh? How are we going to do this? They actually did come up with quite a smart plan, but I'll get onto that in a little bit. But either way, it was very interesting seeing these three couples being put in a brand new position. The game's only going to get more and more toxic the less people there are, so I'm very excited to see how this goes. So, whilst they were all just kind of sitting around, chatting, la la la, kiki, all of that, there were a few things that I noticed. Michael and Adam are deciding to be pretty honest with their gameplay. They openly were like, yeah, we had nothing in our case, so you don't have to worry about us, like we had nothing on our case. They were being genuinely honest. Some people were like, maybe not, maybe they're lying a little bit. Whereas people started to notice that Gary and Leslie were just a little bit more excitable. They had a different air to them. And people started to pick up on the fact that, oh, maybe they could be the people holding the fortune. I thought this was an absolutely fantastic gameplay. I don't know whether this was intentional or whether it was just happening because they were excited to be there. But they managed to get the majority, or a majority of the other couples to vote for them. When Stephen Mangan, who I'm still not sold on him as a host. I don't think he's quite got the flair and the charm quite yet. I'm seeing whether he's just warming up into it. But he asked each of the couples, who do you think has the money? And 4 out of the 10 couples voted for Gary and Leslie, which made them... Basically, Stephen was like, yo, swap your case with the person that you said. And they said the people they thought had the money was Susan and Jen. So Susan and Jen and Gary and Leslie already had to swap cases. And Gary and Leslie went up, opened it. Oh, thank God, there's nothing in there. Brilliant. Susan and Jen opened theirs, saw the early checkout card, and they looked pissed off and angry. They didn't exactly do a very good job of hiding the fact that they had the early checkout card. And Chloe even called them out on it, was like, oh, I think have you got the early checkout card? And Susan was like, I'm not telling you. And Chloe was like, I think they've got it. They've definitely got it. Yeah. Yeah. So yeah, on the whole, this first half of the episode was absolutely fantastic, and now we're going to get into a challenge, and for once, I'm kind of excited to talk about the challenge, because the challenge actually works itself very, very well into the game itself. So, I found it very, very interesting that the challenges actually dictate the order in which the swaps happen. Essentially, you've got to do well in the challenge, otherwise you could be at mercy of getting somebody else's case. For example, if you come first, you will be the last to swap, which means that you can choose which case you get. You can keep your own, or you can decide to swap with who you think has the money, or if you have the early checkout card, you can just give it to someone else. And it just goes down like that. So essentially, if you're first, you're safe. Completely safe. However, if you're last in the challenge, you must swap. Everybody else will get a choice whether they want to keep their case or swap it. but last place has to swap their case. So, with that said, let's get into the challenge. The challenge was basically to race around the island, or like part of an island, and solve riddles and take pictures by the places where the riddles were leading to, I guess. Some people were a lot better than others. Chloe and Louis were having an absolute nightmare with their challenge. I think they managed to get 1 out of 5 correct, so they did end up coming last. They were also the last to make it to the meeting point as well. So it was just a little bit of a faff for them. They didn't do particularly well. There was some people that did incredibly well. I got to hand it to both Michael and Adam and Daniel and Claire, who made it first and second in the race aspect of it. But overall, Daniel and Claire were the winners, and therefore they gained the sort of advantage. You're going to see the order in which they came in a little bit, because obviously we're going to be going through the swapping. But on the whole, very, very impressed with this challenge. It did feel exciting. It did feel exhilarating, because there was actually a reason for this challenge to take place. They weren't just fighting to, build the cash fund. They were actually genuinely fighting for their survival and their safety in this competition, which I actually think makes a lot more sense. It's like if the Traitors just bunned off the whole money situation and made it so that each of the challenges were for shields. That would be so much more interesting. Rather than having shields as like, you can forfeit some money in order to get a shield. No, don't do that. Make it so that it's for the shield, because I can guarantee it's going to be more competitive and it's going to be far more interesting to watch. So it's time to talk about the nightcap at the Lady Luck Bar. I got to say, first of all, they really did sell the idea that this is like more than just a reality show. This is actually like they're living the life of luxury and they're in the Lady Luck Bar. It did really feel quite cool to me, kind of like how you've got like the round table. This is like the Lady Luck Bar. It just added a little bit better than like, oh, let's go to a meeting room. Do you know what I mean? So obviously Chloe and Louis were up first. They had to swap their case. They were like, okay, who do we choose? And obviously, as we know, Chloe and Louis have the money. They actually possess the money. They decided to swap with Will and Joanne, which I found very, very interesting. Like, very, very interesting. Because Chloe and Louis basically just swapped with the other people who had the money. So they still kept the money. There was a net loss of nothing here. I was really impressed. I actually thought this was such a great moment for the whole show. Up next, we had Aisha and Sam. They decided to keep their case, which I thought was a smart choice. If you know you've got nothing in your case, you're better off keeping it than risking swapping and getting the early checkout card. Cherish and Jay decided to keep their case as well. Abby and Tracy also decided to keep their case. As you can see, a lot of people who know they have nothing in their case are making smart choices to not become targets early on and basically leave their cases where they are, because they guarantee themselves safety into next week unless someone else swaps with them. Then we had Leslie and Gary. Leslie and Gary decided to keep their case as well, as did Tommy and Scott, and as did Michael and Adam. So we're now into the top three of the competition, of the challenge that was done earlier. Susan and Jen currently own the early checkout card. The only people that they shouldn't give it to are Joanne and Will and Dan and Claire, because they could just give it straight back to them. However, very, very smartly, they decided to chase the money. They believed that Will and Joanne had the money at the start of the Lady Luck Bar swap around. But now they believe that the money is with Chloe and Louis. And actually, they're incredibly correct. They're 100% correct. So they decided to swap with Chloe and Louis, giving them the early checkout card and essentially forcing them out of the competition. There was no way in hell they were getting out of this after Susan and Jen handed them that card. Later on, Susan and Jen, I can't remember which one's Susan, which one's Jen, but the one with like blondie hair, basically said the reason I did it was because she called us out the like earlier that day and was like, yeah, you have the early checkout card. So I thought, well, fuck you, have this. And I thought, actually, that's kind of perfect. You did kind of redeem yourself a little bit there. Just a little bit. Am I gutted that Chloe and Louis are going to be heading home? Absolutely, but I'll talk more on that in a second. Then we had Joanne and Will. Now, Joanne and Will made the very, very smart choice of going, there is no point us keeping this case that we've been given, because we don't know what's in this case. But we can swap and get our case back, because we know what's in our case, and it will keep us safe. So they decided to swap with Susan and Jen. Basically, exchanging the money again. That's happened twice in one episode. How is this happening? This is incredible. I'm really strapped in. I'm locked in. I'm loaded. I'm really buzzing with this whole show. I'm liking the whole setup and the whole vibe of it. Last but not least, Dan and Claire decided to keep their case. And I think that was a very, very wise choice. Again, they've got nothing in their case. So it's wise to keep nothing before moving on to the next day. Now, Chloe and Louis sadly have left the building. Am I a little bit surprised they went home first? Absolutely. I thought they were going to be there for a little bit longer at least. However, am I kind of grateful that they're not going to be sticking around a little bit? Because I feel like I've already seen enough from Louis, whereas the rest of these people I know nothing about. So like, I am kind of excited to see more of what they have to offer as opposed to what Louis has to offer, which I don't think is much else after what we saw on sort of Josh Must Win. So yeah, that is pretty much it for that part of the episode. But now we've got a very, very interesting plot twist at the end of the episode. You might be thinking, well, hang on a minute. If Chloe and Louis have got the early checkout card, what happens to that checkout card? Like, how do we start getting rid of people? Well, the people who end with the fortune that day can give the early checkout card to one of the other couples, and then it becomes a whole new game, because then that couple has to get rid of the checkout card, but the people with the money know that they have it. So it just becomes a bit of like targeting. I am so goddamn excited for this show, and I hope you guys are as well. But that is all we've got time for today. Thank you guys very, very much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed. Make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. I know I'm late on these videos. This show is going to be ending this week, and I've only just put up episode one, but I will be doing every single episode. And guys, this is basically like The Traitors, but in sunny Caribbean instead of Scotland. So it's so much fun. I'm enjoying myself so much. So thank you guys very, very much for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you guys later. Keep on ranting. Bye now.